स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू विद्या मिराट. दिस वीडियो इज मेड फॉर क्लास 8 ऑन चैप्टर नंबर 4 प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू एक्सरसाइज 4.1. नाउ फॉर दिस एक्सरसाइज यू नीड अ ज्योमेट्री बॉक्स एज वी विल बी डूइंग द कंस्ट्रक्शन. नाउ हियर योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 स्टेट्स दैट यू हैव टू मेक सर्टन क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स एंड द मेजरमेंट्स ऑफ दोज क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स आर गिवन टू यू. नंबर 1, you have to make a quadrilateral ABCD whose measurements are given as AB 4.5, BC 5.5, CD 4 cm, AD 6 cm and AC is equal to 7 cm. So what is the first step what we have to do is we will draw a rough sketch, and your rough sketch will represent like this. Your AC you have given a diagonal also and you are given the four sides also. Now how we are going to do the construction? Let's follow that. Now first of all what you will do is you will draw a line AB 4.5 cm with the help of a scale. Mark the point A and B. Now with the help of a compass what you will do is put your compass point at B and mark 5.5 cm as an arc, and put your compass at A, take 7 cm. You will be needing scale for this point, your compass point and pencil point. Mark it as 7 and cut a arc. Both the arcs should be cut. That point will be marked as C. Now this is half ABC form. We need now D. For that D what we will do is we have the other measurements also. Put your compass at C and take the measurement of 4 on your compass. Draw an arc. Same way, now put the compass on A. Take the measurement of 6 cm and cut the arc. Both the arcs wherever they cut, name that point as D and join the lines. So required will be your ABCD quadrilateral. Same way, let us do the next one. Here we have to make a quadrilateral jump where you are again given all the sides and diagonal given PU as 6.5 cm. So we have already drawn a rough sketch so that we can easily frame and mark our measurements on the compass and scale, and it will be very easier for us to do. First of all, we will draw a straight line JU 3.5 cm and we will take point J and U. We know that from J we want a P point which should be 4.5. So with the help of a compass I will mark 4.5 and cut an arc. Same way I will put a compass point on U and I will mark 6.5 cm. Now before marking what you have to do is take you please keep it on a table or a flat surface. Take your scale, take your compass, so open as per your measurements. After opening the measurements you need not move your compass, okay? Put it on that point, respective points, and draw an arc. After that join JP and join UP. Now half is made. Now we need PM and we need MU. Now what you are going to do is from the point P and from the point U, you will take your measurements. From U, first check the measurement 4 cm with the help of a compass and scale, draw an arc. And from P, cut it on that previous arc and name it as M. So join MP and join MU. This will be your required quadrilateral jump. Third case, you need to draw a parallelogram more where you are given OR as 6 cm, RE as 4.5 cm and EO as 7.5 cm. Now as per the parallelogram property, we know that opposite sides are equal and parallel. We are just given OR as 6, that means ME will also be 6 cm. We are given RE as 4.5 cm which means MO will also be 4.5 cm according to the property of parallelogram. Again we will follow the same method which we have done in the previous questions. Now what we will do is first draw the line OR as 6 cm and take your compass and scale. Mark the measurement 7.5, cut an arc. And from arc, mark the measurement 4.5, cut an arc. Wherever they both cut, mark it as E. That will be E point. Now from E, we need EM and from O, we need OM. So what will I do? With the help of my compass and scale, I will open the measurement 4.5 cm and cut an arc from O. And I will open 6 cm and cut an arc from E. Wherever they meet, I will name it as M. And join the lines, you will get the required parallelogram more. Next, we have to make a rhombus. In this rhombus, best is there where you are given 4.5 centimeter as BE and ET is given 6 centimeters. Now, what is the property of rhombus? All the sides are equal of a rhombus. So, using that property, I know that BE is given to me 4.5, then all other remaining sides will also be 4.5 centimeters. That is SC, ST and TB. All are 4.5. So, let's draw a straight line first, BE 4.5 centimeters, and take a scale, take a compass, mark 4.5 from B and mark 6 centimeters from E. Cut the arc wherever they cut, name it as T. So, why we are doing it like this? See, when we draw a rough sketch or rough diagram, it becomes very easier for us to draw. Otherwise, we might face difficulty. Okay. Half of this is made. Again, we need 4.5 centimeters from T and E. Cut the arc and wherever they cut, we will name it as S and then join all the lines BE, ES, ST, TB, TE. All that form is best as a required rhombus. So with this, we end up with this exercise 4.1. It was very easy, very simple. Now see that it is not necessary all the side measurements are given. Like in the case of parallelogram, only two sides were given you the measurement. So you should know in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. So you can easily tell what will be the measurements of the other side. In the case of rhombus, only one side is given to you and a diagonal. We know the property of a rhombus, all the sides are equal. So we can easily find out all other sides and then make it. And please make a rough sketch, rough diagram, freehand on your rough hand side and then start doing the construction part. Do it very neatly. Your pencil should be pointed and don't play with the compass with the sharp things. Okay. Very soon I am going to come up with exercise 4.2. Till then, see you children. Goodbye. Take care.